Hey guys, welcome to Digit.in, and Google I/O was jam-packed full of interesting announcements, but the one we have all been waiting for was Android P. We downloaded the Android P beta on our Google Pixel 2 XL the minute it went live so we could bring you a better look at what the new OS has to offer. So here are five new features that you should check out on the Google Android P beta. The first thing you will notice is the quick settings menu. The first pull gives you access to the most common shortcuts, but the look has changed. There's still the white background, but instead of it being translucent, it is now a solid white box with rounded edges. The settings buttons themselves now have a circle around them, clearly marking each button. Toggling a setting on will turn it blue, and turning it off grays the setting. Even the accept and decline buttons that pop up when your phone is unlocked have been redesigned. Next up is the redesigned navigation with the help of gestures. For example, you can simply drag the white bar at the bottom left or right to scrub between apps. If you just swipe up, the multitasking window opens first. If you look for the app drawer, you're going to have to swipe up once more. Also, the new multitasking interface looks just like the one on Windows Phone or the one we've seen on the iPhone X. Next, we have the new adaptive brightness settings in the battery menu. This is essentially an AI-based feature which monitors apps' usage and then limits the background calls by apps that are not frequently used. By doing so, it prevents the CPU from being woken up by unnecessary apps, consequently preserving battery drain. This feature will become better over time as the AI learns your usage behavior, so I can't really say if it is working for now or not. At number 4, we have the settings menu, which has also received a redesign. You get new icons and a more colorful theme now. The submenus have also been optimized and many sub-options have been put under the advanced submenu for every settings. This is pretty handy, but if you're not the kind who likes jumping between setting screens, you can always just search for whatever it is you are looking for. Last but not least, Google has now enabled a new way to interact with your apps. The slice and app actions will surface in the app drawer based on what you do the most within apps you use most frequently. Those actions will show up at the very top of the app drawer, a rather convenient way to do certain things. So there you have it, guys. That was a look at five cool features of the upcoming Android P operating system. You can always let us know what you thought of this video in the comment section below. And for more videos like this one, you can subscribe to our channel. We will catch you in another video. It's goodbye for now.